International Conference on Agriculture and Forestry.
I am Darshini Singh Halagi. First of all, I will move into the introduction. Strawberry, which is a delicious fruit, scientifically named as Fragaria anisa, which is categorized under the family Rosaceae. This berry crop is commercially cultivated in 63 countries around the world. In Sri Lanka, this crop is common in Nuwareliya and Badulla districts where there are low temperatures. One of the major problems associated with strawberry cultivation is application of heavy doses of chemical fertilizers. In this table, it is figured out the application of chemical fertilizers for strawberry for a growing season. It is very high. The usage of chemical fertilizers or the application of high doses of chemical fertilizers diminish the soil quality and fertility in long term. In addition, it will end up with many environmental problems as well as health issues. Therefore, many scientists try to reduce the usage of chemical fertilizers by modifying the cultivation practices of strawberry while maintaining the quality of the strawberry. Such examples are usage of grass mulches, usage of biofertilizers combining with chemical fertilizers, usage of combination of biofertilizers, chemical fertilizers and growth hormones. In some scientists used a combination of more microbial cultures or co-culturing. Microorganisms like Acer spirillum, Acetobacter, Bacillus strains and Pseudomonas strains have been recorded in literature as a strawberry plant growth promoting as well as quality enhancing microorganisms. Use of biofilm biofertilizer has introduced recently. What is this biofilm biofertilizer? In this case, what scientists are doing, first they are developing biofilms under in vitro condition. After that, they introduce this biofilm into the carrier-based materials by forming biofilm biofertilizers. The major role of biofilm biofertilizers is to enhance soil sustainability through increased microbial diversity and functioning. Biofilm, as well as biofilm biofertilizer, is a new concept. In this figure, what you may see, a fungal filament attached by bacteria by forming a biofilm. And this we can use as a biofilm biofertilizer. There are many benefits associated with the biofilm biofertilizers as a plant growth promoter. Such examples are nitrogen fixation and phosphorus solubilization via the reduced pH of the environment and production of plant growth promoting substances like indole acetic acid, and they have the biocontrolling effect. And this has proven in many crops the reduction of usage of chemical fertilizer. This has proven in crops like rice, maize, wheat, etc. And the major role is the increase of microbial diversity, thus improving ecosystem functioning and sustainability. From this point, I will move into the major problem and objective of this researcher. As I mentioned earlier, the major problem of this research work is the usage of heavy chemical fertilizers. The objective of this research is to evaluate the effects of microbes originated from the strawberry rhizosphere on the growth of strawberry. Methodology that I followed. All the laboratory experiments I conducted in microbial biotechnology lab of IFS, and field experiments were conducted in Agricultural Research Station Sitailia. Treatments. There were three major types of treatments I used. The first type is the microbial cultures isolated from strawberry rhizosphere and their formulation. In this figure, you may see in the first one, a bacterial strain that I use. It is a gram-positive rod-shaped one. In the second one, aspergillus-like fungal strain. Third one to fifth one, simple fungal bacterial biofilms. That means a biofilm in between fungal strain and a bacterial strain. A last one, one of the higher order biofilms that I have used, it is a biofilm in between a fungal strain and two bacterial strains. A second type of treatments that I used was the microbial cultures isolated from strawberry rhizosphere and their formulations coupled with 25, 50 and 75% of recommended chemical fertilizers. A third type of treatments were 0, 25%, 50%, 75% and 100% of recommended chemical fertilizers. When coupled with all three types of treatments, altogether there were 29 types of treatments. Then the before apply the treatment into the pot soil, I measure the growth pH of microbial culture. According to this figure, you may see a bacterial strain and fungal strain were in the acidic region, whereas all the biofilms, other cultures were in the basic region. The maximum pH was shown by the simple fungal bacterial biofilm BF2. I measure the nitrogenase activity of microbial culture by using acetylene reduction assay in GC. According to the results obtained through this assay, a simple fungal bacterial biofilm BF2 showed the nitrogenase activity, whereas all the other cultures haven't showed the nitrogenase activity under the detection limit used in the GC of this experiment. Pot experiment, I used forest soil as a growth medium in here. First, I filled the grow bags with forest soil. After that, strawberry runners from G1 generation has planted in forest soil and kept for rooting. After 2 weeks period, I applied the treatment. Microbial cultures were diluted 15 times and 20 milliliters of inoculum were introduced to the pot soil. At the same time, different doses of chemical fertilizers has introduced. The treatment application were continued within 2 month intervals. And the experimental design was CRD, and I used 3 replicates in here per treatment. Then the pot experiment was maintained for 6 month period, and data were collected. The recorded data were time of flowering, number of flowers, time of fruit set and number of fruit set, and the final harvest in number and in mass. Finally, I analyzed the data by using general linear model, and means were separated by Tookie's mean separation test. Then I will. I am in the most important part of this research, results. In this slide, you may see a different developmental stages of strawberry in a pot experiment. In first figure, you may see the development stage of strawberry at the time of first treatment application. In second and third ones, the different developmental stages. And in fourth one, flowering, next one, fruiting, and the last one, you may see the mature fruits. I created a phenological calendar for the pot experiments from August 2013 to January 2014. In here, you may see a development, flowering, fruit setting, and harvesting times of times under different treatments. According to this figure, you may see the early flowering was shown by BF2 coupled with 50% of chemical fertilizers, BF3 coupled with 75% of chemical fertilizers, and HO coupled with 25% of chemical fertilizers. This double-headed arrow in the middle is demarcate the time of initiation of pollination. Then the fruit set has initiated after the pollination, fruit set has initiation. According to this diagram, you may see 75% chemical fertilizer treatment, BF3 plus 75% chemical fertilizer treatment, and HO plus 25% of chemical fertilizer treatment showed the early fruit setting. The early harvest was shown by BF alone and BF1 plus 25% of chemical fertilizers and BF3 plus 25% of chemical fertilizers. At the end of 6 months, all the treatments produce mature fruits except HO plus 50% chemical fertilizer and HO plus 75% of chemical fertilizers. Development of flowers per bunch under different treatment. This factor was significant in BF1 plus 50% of chemical fertilizers. Anyway, a treatment like 75% of chemical fertilizers, 100% of chemical fertilizers, BF3 plus 50% of chemical fertilizers, and HO also good for flower production per bunch. Fruit sets under the different treatment. The fruit set was significant in 75% of chemical fertilizer treatment. However, B plus 25% chemical fertilizer treatment, BF1 plus 75% chemical fertilizer treatment, and BF3 plus 50% chemical fertilizer treatment also good treatment for fruit sets. Harvest in number under different treatments. The harvest number was significant in B plus 25% of chemical fertilizer treatment. F plus 25% chemical fertilizer and BF2 plus 50% chemical fertilizer also notified treatments for the production of higher number of fruits. harvest in mass under different treatments. Harvest in this factor was significant in BF2 plus 50% of chemical fertilizer, whereas it also well notified in B plus 25% of chemical fertilizers and BF3 plus 25% of chemical fertilizers. Relative sizes of harvest in best for treatments. According to this study, the best for treatment for mass of the fruits were F plus 25% of chemical fertilizers, B plus 25% of chemical fertilizers, BF2 plus 25% of chemical fertilizers, and BF2 plus 50% of chemical fertilizers. In here, it is very clear the relative size of fruits is larger in under the treatment of BF2 plus 50% of chemical fertilizers, whereas all the other treatments produce the fruits with smaller size. So now it is very clear this BF2 plus 50% chemical fertilizer treatment produced the higher masses. That means the harvest is in mass height, it is high than the other treatments. And I compared the yield of my best treatment with the two recent studies. According to the acid can studies, the yield increase over the control was 33. It is 146 for Uma's study, but in my study, the yield increase over the control is 637. Now it is very clear. I use a simple fungal bacterial biofilm coupled with 50% of chemical fertilizer as a biofertilizer in this experiment. The action of fungal bacterial biofilm is higher or the superior than the monoculture based biofertilizers in the point of production. Fruiting strength of biofertilizers when coupled with different chemical fertilizer levels. In the fifth figure, you may see the fruiting strength of fungal strain. In there also, fruiting strength is maximum when the fungal strain coupled with 70 to 80% of chemical fertilizers. In second figure, you may see the fruiting strength of bacterial strains. In there also, the maximum yield was shown when bacterial strain coupled with uh, 20 to 40% of chemical fertilizers. In here, you may see the fruiting strength of a simple fungal bacterial biofilm BF1. And here, the fruiting strength of simple fungal bacterial BF2. This was the best treatment for fruit production in this experiment. In here, it is very clear in this area, it gave the maximum yield when it is coupled with 30 to 50% of chemical fertilizer. And also, we can see another very good observation in these graphs. If we consider the chemical fertilizers start to respond when the level is in 50. But when we consider the biofertilizers, if there are no any chemical fertilizer added, they have the response. They have the response in some extent. But the maximum is given when the biofertilizer coupled with the some amount of chemical fertilizers. In here, you may see the protein strength of simple fungal bacterial biofilm BF3. In there also, the maximum yield is given in this area when coupled it with 30 to 40% of chemical fertilizers. In here, the protein strength of higher order biofilm. From this point, I will arrive into the conclusions of this research. The conclusions can be arrived as fungal bacterial biofilm BF2. Increase the yield characteristics of strawberry when coupled with 50% of recommended chemical fertilizers. Therefore, there is a high potential of using fungal bacterial biofilm as a biofertilizer in strawberry to reduce the usage of chemical fertilizers while maintaining a high fruit production. And I would like to acknowledge Dr. Mangalika Nugalia, the research officer in charge, Agricultural Research Station Sita Elia, for her facilitation me to carry on the PROTECT experiments in Agricultural Research Station premises. I also thank Ms. Kumudini Karunaratna, technical officer, who assisted me to carry on the laboratory experiments. These are the cited references in this presentation. And this is the end of this presentation. Thank you very much.